I could spare his life, if I could trade his life for mine, he'd be standing here right now, and you would smile, and that would be enough. I don't pretend to know the challenges we're facing. I know there's no replacing what we've lost, and you need time. But I'm not afraid. I know who I married. Just let me stay here by your side. That would be enough.
If you see me in the street, walking by your side, talking by your side, I'll be.
Eliza, do you like it uptown? It's quiet uptown.
He is trying to do the unimaginable. Walking in the park, long after dark, taking in the sights of the city.
Look around, look around, Eliza.
They are trying to do the unimaginable.
There are moments that the words don't reach. There's a grace too powerful to name. We push away, but we can never understand. We push away the unimaginable. They are standing in the garden, Alexander by Eliza's side. She takes his hand. It's quiet uptown.
Forgiveness.
What I want. And you know what? I learned that from you. It's a tie.
If you had to choose, if you had to choose.
It's up to the delegates.
If you had to choose, if you had to choose.
It's up to the delegates.
If you had to choose, if you had to choose. If you had to choose, if you had to choose.
Go.
Go.
The people are asking to hear my voice.
Go.
For the country is facing a difficult choice.
Go.
And if you were to ask me who I would vote.
Go.
Jefferson has my vote. Beliefs. Burr has none.
Well, I'll be damned. Well, I'll be damned.
Hamilton's on your side.
Well, I'll be damned. Well, I'll be damned.
Man,
you won in a landslide.
Congrats on the race well run. I did give you a fight. I look forward to our partnership.
Our partnership
as your vice president. Yeah, right. You hear this guy? Man openly campaigns against me, talking about I look forward to our partnership.
It's crazy for the guy who comes in second, gets to be vice president.
You know what? We can change that. You know why?
Why?
Because I'm the president. Burr, when you see Hamilton, thank him for the endorsement.
How does Hamilton, an arrogant immigrant orphan, bastard, poor son, somehow endorse Thomas Jefferson, his enemy, a man he despised since the beginning, just to keep me from winning?
I'll be in the room where it happens, the room where it happens, the room where it happens. You kept me from the room where it happens for the last time. I told a lie, as I reckoned with the effects of your life on mine. I look back on where I failed, and in every place I checked, the only common thread has been your disrespect. Now you call me amoral, a dangerous disgrace. If you've got something to say, name a time and place, face to face. I have the honor to be your obedient servant. A. Dot Burr.
Mr. Vice President, I am not the reason no one trusts you. No one knows what you believe. I will not equivocate on my opinion. I have always worn it on my sleeve. Even if I said what you think I said, you would need to cite a more specific grievance. Here's an itemized list of 30 years of disagreement. Sweet Jesus! Hey, I am not shy. I am just a guy in the public eye trying to do my best for our republic. I don't want to fight, but I won't apologize for doing what's right. I have the honor to be your obedient servant. Ain't that hack?
Careful how you proceed, good man. Intemperate indeed, good man. Answer for the accusations I lay at your feet. Or prepare to be, good man.
Your grievance is legitimate. I stand by what I said. Every bit of it, you stand only for yourself. It's what you do. I can't apologize because it's you.
Stand, Alexander.
We hawken.
Dog. Guns. Wrong. You're wrong.
I have the honor to be your obedient servant.
A. Dot Hack.
A. Dot Burr.
Best of women.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
There are 10 things you need to know.
Number 1.
We rolled across the Hudson at dawn. My friend William P. Van Ness signed on as my
number 2.
Hamilton arrived with his crew, Nathaniel Pendleton, and the doctor that he knew.
Number 3.
I watched Hamilton examine the terrain. I wish I could tell you what was happening in his brain. This man has poisoned my political pursuits.
Moses is new.
Position, looking to the world like a man on a mission. This is a soldier with a marksman's ability. The doctor turned around so he could have deniability.
5.
Now I didn't know this at the time, but we were near the same spot. My son died, is that why? He examined his gun with such rigor. I watched as he methodically fiddled with the trigger.
7.
The present time, here's what I got. My fellow soldiers will tell you I'm a terrible shot.
Number 8.
Last chance to negotiate. Send in your second CEO, they can set the record straight.
Now they won't teach you this in your classes, but look it up. Hamilton was wearing his glasses. Why? You're not to take deadly aim. It's him or me. The world will never be the same. I had only one thought before the slaughter. This man will not make an orphan of my daughter.
Number 9.
Look at me.
Is this where it gets me? On my feet, several feet ahead of me. I see it coming. Do I run or fire my gun or let it be?
There is no beat, no melody. Burn, my first friend, my enemy, maybe the last face I ever see. If I throw away my shot, is this how you remember me? What if this bullet is my legacy? Legacy?
What is a legacy? It's planting seeds in a garden you never get to see. I wrote some notes at the beginning of a song someone will sing for me. America, you great unfinished symphony you sent for me. You let me make a difference. A place where even orphan immigrants can leave their fingerprints and rise up. I'm running out of time. I'm running out of my time. Up, wise up, eyes up.
I catch a glimpse of the other side. Lawrence leads a soldier's chorus on the other side. My son is on the other side. He's with my mother on the other side. Washington is watching from the other side. Teach me how to say goodbye. Rise up, rise up, rise up, and rise up.
My love, take your time. I'll see you on the other side. Raise a glass to freedom.
Give this pistol out the sky.
I strike him right between his ribs. I walk towards him while I usher him away. They row him back across the Hudson. I get a drink. I hear wailing in the streets. Somebody tells me you better hide. They say Angelica and Liza were both at his side when he died. Death doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes. History illiterate with every picture it paints. It paints me with all of my mistakes. And Alexander aimed at the sky. He may have been the first one to die, but I'm the one who paid for it. I survived, but I paid for it. Now I'm a villain in your history. I was too young and blind to see. I should have known the world was wide enough for both Hamilton and me. The world was wide enough for both Hamilton and me.
let me tell you what a bitch I know. When I was young and dreamed of glory, you have no control.
This who dies, who tells your story?
President Jefferson, I'll give him this. His financial system is a work of genius. I couldn't undo it if I tried. And I tried.
President Madison,
he took our country from bankruptcy to prosperity. I hate to admit it, but he does not get enough credit for all the credit he gave us.
Every other founding father's story gets told. Every other founding father gets to grow old.
And when you're gone, who remembers your name? Who keeps your fame? Who tells your story?
It's not-